Hey everyone, hope you're having a wonderful day. I wanted to ask you guys a question today. Have you ever wondered why people hop into relationships with the wrong people? You know, I've heard so many singles say these types of phrases to themselves. They say, "I just cannot be happy until I'm married. My life won't start until after I get married." They'll say stuff like, "If I'm not married by the time I'm 30 years old, I'll just be miserable. By that point, if God hasn't done something, I'm just going to take it into my own hands and make it happen." They'll say things like, "I feel so empty on the inside. Surely getting married will fix this void that I'm feeling in my heart." They say things like, "I struggle with lust really badly in my life. Maybe if I get married, this little problem will go away." When in reality, the sad reality is a lot of times it'll actually get worse. If you went in with lust before marriage, a lot of times that'll get even worse after you get married. Amen. And so I want to tell you guys today that there's a lot of reasons why people get into relationships. Sometimes it's because they're lonely. Sometimes it's because, you know, they've got these things that they're struggling with in their own life and they're hoping that a person is going to fix it. And I want to tell you guys today, that's just not true. Jesus is the one who can fix that stuff. And desperation will cause you to settle in your personal life, and it can cause damage that can really mess you up down the line. This is what leads to divorces. This is what leads to all kinds of marital problems down the line. And so you've got to be sure that you're doing things for the right reasons and that God is filling you up so that it doesn't cause you to be in a bad place down the line. You know, there's a phrase that I like to use, which is, "Don't shop when you're hungry." Okay, so I have a rule for myself now before I go to the grocery store, and I've had it for a long time now, that I have to eat something, whether it's a snack or a meal, right before I go to the grocery store. If not, because I'm so hungry, I will end up buying things that I do not need and putting them in my cart. Amen? How many of you guys have been there before? And so this concept applies to relationships as well. Don't shop when you're hungry. Let God fill that void in your personal life. Because if you are just dating someone or hopping into a relationship because you're lonely, that's never going to end well. And let me tell you why, ladies and gents. Loneliness can make you ignore very important red flags that can lead to trouble down the line. Desperation can make you ignore red flags that will lead to trouble down the line in that relationship and in your personal life. Amen. You've got to get to the place where if you encounter someone unhealthy in a dating relationship, you are able to walk away from that situation and go, "You know what? I'm fine with just me and Jesus. You know, I'd like to have you as a part of my life. I'd like for you to be there. But if it comes down to it, this unhealthiness is not going to lead my life. You know, I am fine being on my own, single as a Pringle, with just me and God." You guys, when you get to that place, you're probably healthy enough to start dating. Amen. You're probably healthy enough to say, "God, I'm ready for you to introduce me to my future spouse." Amen. But if you're so to that place where it's a desperation on the inside of you, where it's a, "I've got to have this or else I'm never going to be happy with my life," you haven't quite hit the place of God filling that void of, you know, loneliness or whatever it is in your life that you need to let him fill. Now, let me just also say, there's nothing wrong with desiring to get married and desiring to be in a relationship. Often God puts that on your heart. But if you are so invested in something that you are unable to walk away from it, if it's unhealthy before marriage, that's a problem, ladies and gents. You know, and loneliness or desperation will cause you to ignore really important problems when they come up just because you so have this idea that you have fantasized about, that you really like about being married to a particular person. Amen. And that's just not good, guys. You got to have good boundaries. You got to run this stuff by Jesus. And you know, you've got to be okay with letting God fill you up first. And only then can God introduce you to the right person and you guys can walk in healthy relationship together when it is the right thing. Amen. So never, ever let loneliness, let any of those phrases that I just read you guys, be the root cause behind you getting into a relationship. You know the reason you should get into a relationship, ladies and gents, is because God's calling you to it. Is because he has picked that person out for you, is because you guys are aligned with purpose, you both love Jesus, you're both on fire for the Lord, you're both in a good place, and you want to run after him together because it's going to make your lives better, and it's going to make the gospel better because it lines up with his will. That's why you need to be getting into relationships, ladies and gents. But you got to let God fill you up first, otherwise you're going to keep attracting unhealthy. You're going to keep getting yourself in these situations, you know, out of a place of loneliness or desperation, and you're looking looking for this other person to fill the void when really you need to be looking to God to do that stuff in order to attract and gain healthy relationships and attention down the line. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you soon.